If they ask you a question you don't know, then your response should be a genuine, let me find out the answer because I care about you, right? They should feel that in your voice. They should see it on your face that, I don't know, let me find that out. Boom, got the answer. Boom, got right back to them. So the first thing you need to know about real estate is that it's a super simple concept to succeed. The problem is there's so many different avenues you can take, and so many people are telling you so many different things and different directions you can go in. And so you gotta kind of, I guess, not listen to most of this stuff, because most of it is garbage. You know, there's 20, 30 different ways to build your business. You really need to figure out what the top one or two things are and really just go all in there. And when you're new, you don't know what those top one or two things are because everybody's different. Everybody has different strengths and weaknesses. So you got to kind of test things out as you go along and see what works. But I'll tell you what every single activity is going to come back to, no matter where, what direction you try to go in, every activity is going to come right back to real conversations with people. Okay. Regardless if you get your leads online or open houses or sphere of influence or cold calling or whatever the case may be, it's all going to come back to having a conversation. When you get that Zillow lead, realtor.com, Facebook lead, you got to call them right then. Some people try to avoid that. They get the online lead and then they text them, right? That you're just prolonging the inevitable. And until we actually have a real conversation with someone, there's never going to be an even a chance of a deal happening. For the most part, you can get lucky here and there, but for the most part, if we really want to, you know, pour gasoline on this and take it to the next level, you got to have as many conversations as you can have, because a real conversation is the key to every single closing. There's not going to be a closing without a real conversation in there somewhere. And if that's the common denominator, common sense tells me if we want to have as many closings as we can have, we got to have as many conversations as we can have. I just want to know that you're getting enough leads, or you've got enough people to get on the phone with and have conversations with back to back to back to back to back every day, 50% of your time. If you're a full-time agent, that's 9 to 12 every day. 9 to 12 every day, you need to be on the phone back to back to back to back to back, whether you're calling, you know, your internet leads, or you're just cold calling property owners, or you're calling your sphere, or you're calling, you know, people that went to your open house yesterday. I don't care who you're calling, as long as you're calling people in the market, trying to create friendships with them, right? And trying to find out what you can do to help them, all right? And just continue to build. It's a snowball. The more friendships you accumulate in the market, the bigger your business is going to be. And if you have a foundation like a weekly email in place, whereas everyone you run into never forgets who you are, once you make that great first impression, they never forget who you are. Think about how massive your business would be if you picked up 5 new friends a day, right? That's 25 in a week, 100 in a month, 1,200 in a year, 24, 36, 48, let's call it 5,000 in 4 years. Think about how massive your business would be if you have 5,000 people, property owners preferably, in your market who talk to you, loved you, created a friend with, and get a weekly, they have been getting a weekly email from you from the day they met you. I buy property owners' contact information for 2 cents a piece just to call and make friends with them forever, followed by a weekly email that costs me pennies as well. That's my entire game plan, guys. Okay, like, I'm not spending any money on any kind of marketing, you know, anything crazy. You can literally build this business on nothing but just sweat equity, okay? And just getting out there. Think of yourself as a politician. You want to get out there. You want to make friends in the market. You want to canvas the market. Let as many property owners know who you are, what you do, and you're here to help, right? And you build your brand on the back of that. It's really as simple as that, you know? So in the beginning, you're at that 50-50. So you got to figure out how many hours you're allocating towards real estate per week. Some new agents are full-time for some reason. Most of them are part-time. So you got to figure out where that allocation is. If you're like a 9-to-5 Monday through Friday, I suggest a 1-hour huge call session every Saturday for like 4 hours. Make that be your mandatory call session and run your marketing and do your trainings and do all your other stuff during the week. You know, don't pressure yourself to make calls during the week. If you get a call session in during the week, great. If you have this kind of job where you get off at 2 o'clock in the evening and you got the rest of the day to do something, something, make a couple call sessions during the week. It just kind of depends on what your, you know, what everybody's situation is different. I like to look at everybody's situation specifically and try to carve out a good game plan for them. But 50-50 is good in the beginning for like the first month or two till you get that first lump of training past you, and then kind of go to more of a 70-30, you know, 70% building your business. And you just have to go through that. Everybody goes through it. This is not easy. You own your own business. Most people don't understand owning your own business. They grew up, you know, working by the hour. You get paid to show up no matter what you produce. Over here, you only get paid if you produce. And man, is it hard to get going. It's kind of like pushing a truck, you know, it's really hard to push, but once you get it going, it's easy. You just can kind of lightly tap it and it keeps going. Same thing here. So much energy goes into that first couple years, but once you get the momentum, it can be really easy to keep the momentum going if you're building a personal brand on the back of a mechanism in place, a machine that allows no one to forget who you are once you meet them. If you don't have that mechanism in place, then you're just starting over every day. You just have to get out there and start pushing that truck from stop every single day, you know. And what are you scared of? Nothing. I mean, if I ask you what you're scared of, you're going to tell me either nothing, or you're going to tell me rejection, or you're going to tell me you're scared to look dumb. One of those three things. And neither of those three things matter at all, right? You know, if you don't know what you're scared of, then obviously rejection, who cares? Okay, who cares? And if you look dumb, who cares? Here's the thing. You shouldn't be worried about looking dumb. You should be worried about looking like you don't care about people, right? You should be worried about looking like you don't care. If they ask you a question you don't know, then your response should be a genuine, let me find out the answer because I care about you, right? They should feel that in your voice. They should see it on your face that, I don't know, let me find that out. Boom, got the answer. Boom, got right back to them. That shows that you care. You're not going to know the answer to every single question, right? So don't worry about looking dumb. Worry about looking like you don't care about someone. And if you have your confidence should be backed by the fact that your intentions are there to genuinely help people. And so at that point, you shouldn't care what anybody thinks. You shouldn't care what happens. There should be no situation that you're put in that makes you feel awkward because you know that you're there to help someone. Now, if you're there not to help people, just to help yourself, which is what most coaches and trainers are teaching agents, then yeah, that's a scary place to be. If you're there just for you, or if you're following this strategy of, I'm just trying to sell a property to make a commission off of you, not necessarily caring why you're doing it, or you know what the situation is. New content on every email where it's not the same old crap every email, number one. Number two, you don't have a novel, right? You don't have you only have like a few sentences in really big font, and he says click here, right? You always have the new listings, right? Have a link on your website that's always updated with the new listings. People are like, new listings, new listings, new listings. I gotta see what the new listings are. I'm gonna check that email every week because I want to know what the new listings are. You got the closed sales on there. You got a property search. Maybe one week of the month you have your deal of the month. Your deal of the month, and it has to be something that's really a deal, not just something, right? Something that you feel like is really a good deal. You've got a restaurant. Maybe you do a restaurant of the month. You know, where somewhere you went, and you can actually tell your story. When you start telling your opinions on stuff, not just sending information, but like telling what you think about the information, that's when people really start tuning into you, right? When you say, look, you know, you guys really need to try this place. You know, me and my husband went there last week. I had the whatever and it was amazing. Reply back for a chance to win a $20 gift card. You know, reply back for a chance to win a $20 gift card. People reply back. It gives engagement. You go back and forth with them. One of them wins. The rest of them, you say, listen, I'm sorry you didn't make it, but let me take you to lunch there sometime. Boom. Now you're meeting them in person. 1 week can be stats. You know, 1 week of the month can be stats of the month, you know, where you actually go through the numbers and you give those analytical people their fix. They want to know what the numbers are, the price per square foot, the increase in this and inventory and prices and all that stuff. And so you just make it interesting.